understand. And here's your option. No map. A map that's not so good, but has some things about it, or a great map. Well, right. Obviously the great map is the thing you want,
yeah.
But the map that's something is way better than the map that's nothing. Plus, as you explore, because of your map, you could start to fill in the details.
And you start to learn, and you start to overcome stuff, and you start to master skills on your journey, right?
Yeah, well, that's the other thing, too, is like, let's say you aim at something, and you develop some skills along the way. And then you get like a third of the way there and you think, oh, that's not for me. It's like, well, yeah, fair enough. But now you've still got the skills you developed. You know exactly why it's not for you now instead of vaguely.
So you don't have to keep going after that
Exactly, exactly. And well, and you have a rationale.
Yeah.
And then you can bring that wisdom back, even though it's not perfect. You can bring it back to your next plan. And so.
And take responsibility for the next steps. Yeah.
Yes, yes. And so as you plan, you get better at planning, which is the crucial thing. So then we say to people, take your positive vision and make it into 8 statable goals, right? So, and then rank them in a hierarchy because you need to know what...
Like a top goal and then incremental goals.
Yeah, and that, well, that's the other thing, is break the goals into incremental goals so that you have a reasonable probability of succeeding. So, because what you want to do, this is also what you want to do with a kid. You don't tell your kid, here's an impossible thing, why don't you go out and fail? You say... Here's something worth going after. Here's a step you could take that would push you beyond where you are, but that you also have a reasonably high probability of succeeding at.
Mm-hmm.
Right? They call that
within a time frame.
Some time frame. That's the other thing. You have to parameterize it with regards to time frame. That's right. And that puts you in the zone of proximal development. And that's a concept that was generated by a guy named Vygotsky. He was a Russian developmental psychologist and a smart one. It's where the idea of the zone comes from, to be in the zone.
Yes.
And when you're in the zone, you're expanding your skills in a manner that's intrinsically rewarding because you're succeeding. And so you want to set, if you're good to yourself, you think, okay, I need to set a goal, but I need to set a goal that someone as stupid and useless as me could probably attain if they put some effort into it.
Right.
And then you've got it perfectly because it's not so high that it's grandiose or impossible that you fail necessarily and then justify your bitterness. It's like, well, I could do well, because that happens to people.
Happens all the time.
Yeah, it's like.
See this all the time.
You know, it's like, yes, exactly. Well, I set a goal and I didn't attain it, so I'm not going to set any more goals.
Right.
It's like, no, you set a goal that was inappropriate.
For the time frame.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's right. You didn't calibrate it properly.
Yeah.
And you're playing a trick on yourself because you wanted to fail so that you could justify not having to try.
And being a victim.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Which isn't helpful. You're still going to be a victim. It's like, there's no way out of that, man.
Yeah.
So, you know, because life is a challenge that in some sense can't be surmounted. So there's no way out of your problem, but there are certainly proper ways of dealing with it.
Yeah.
And so you lay out
those eight steps.
Yep.
Right.
Yeah. Lay them out. And then the next thing is, okay, you need a rationale for them because you're going to have doubts and people are going to put up obstacles.
Is that a meaning you mean? Is that a meaning? A rationale means a meaning?
Yeah. Yeah. A justification.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, so here, what sort of justification is a good justification for your goals? It's easy. Why would it be good for you? Okay. Why would it be good for your family if you attained that goal? Why would it be good for the broader community? Because if it's a good goal, it should be good for you. That's fine. But if it's a really good goal, it should be good for you in a way that's good for other people.
Win, win, win.
Yes, exactly. And if you're going to decide what your goals are, why not set up the ones that benefit the largest number of people simultaneously?
Yeah.
Yes. If you can do that, you should start with your own concerns because you have to take care of yourself.
Basic needs first.
Yes. Put your own
family.
Oxygen mask on, then put your child's oxygen
community.
Mask on. Yeah. Right. And then you can, as you...